And also on the program tonight, Gerard Mulligan. Gerard Mulligan. Gerard Mulligan has been with me on the various shows that I've done since I've been in television, and he's spent 25 years as a writer on this show, and tonight is his very last night. He is retiring, and we're all very, very sad that he's leaving, but happy that he's going on to another wonderful, exciting part of his life. We'll be talking to Gerard Mulligan. That's the big show tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. It's difficult to imagine coming to work without the gentleman we're about to introduce. After 25 years as a writer and a colleague of ours, he's retiring today. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our very funny and talented friend, Gerard Mulligan. Gerard. To believe, is it?
It's amazing. Yeah, just
25 years. Yeah. We started together on the old morning show. Is that right?
Starting on the morning show.
And is there anybody in the group now that started with us on the morning show?
Barbara Gaines over here at the
Barbara
podium.
Barbara Gaines, right?
Jude Brennan.
My
friend Biff Henderson.
Mm-hmm.
And yourself.
That's that's right.
That's it.
Wow.
They're falling like flies. You know, it's a tough gig.
Tell people about your background and stuff like that. And...
Well, okay. I grew up in Rhode Island, Cranston, Rhode Island. I went to Catholic schools all my life.
Right.
I think Catholics. And I planned to be a college English teacher. In fact, I was a college English teacher for about 10 years.
Right.
And one thing led to another. And I wound up in San Francisco. And people were doing stand-up. I was doing stand-up there. And wound up going to Los Angeles. A friend of mine, Meryl Marco, started dating you.
Right.
We met. And very soon after, you started doing guest hosting The Tonight Show, and I started writing material for you.
And at what point along the way did you realize that you were, in addition to everything else, funny?
In addition to everything else. I was really smart, and I still am.
Yeah.
And it's true. I mean, but at any rate, and I was just an unbelievable nerd. And so the nuns skipped me two grades.
Mm-hmm.
So by the time I got to high school, I was this porky little dweeb, mm-hmm. and younger, 2 years younger than everybody else, and getting really good grades and just being really miserable. And then one day in class, not that different from my life now that I think about it, but one day in class, I made a joke, and the whole class went nuts, and I was just out of control.
Do you remember the joke?
I remember the joke, and it's going to seem so lame now, but if you were a 14-year-old boy back in the early, late 50s, it would kill you.
Yeah.
Anyway, I was at a Christian Brothers high school in Providence called LaSalle Academy, and had a brother, Eugene, who was a homeroom teacher, and, you know, 14, 15-year-old boys, and I was 13, which is tough, and... Brother Eugene had just come back from a nervous breakdown. So, no, seriously, I mean, it happens, you know? It was like a sabbatical. You do it every few months. And so he came back, and it was like Lord of the Flies in that classroom. It really was. And so he said, well, some reason Gene Autry's name came up, and he said, you know, I could tell you boys a story about myself and Gene Autry, but I'm not going to tell you. So we all, come on. So he said, oh, well, very well. I was the director of a reform school in upstate New York, and Gene Autry came to visit once. Mm. And, well, I held Gene Autry's hat while he went to the bathroom. And I was just on automatic pilot. I don't remember thinking. I just remember saying, did it get soggy? So, I mean, okay, you know?
And you're off and running.
And I'm off and running. And with, you know, with 14-year-old boys, that's like Oscar Wilde. I mean, that was brilliant, you know? And so for the rest of the time, I got all straight A's, and they would write in the bottom, deportment, F.
Oh,
every time, and yet,
that's
what I did.
We're looking for.
That's exactly.
People who have failed deportment.
People who failed deportment and smart.
And now, 25 years and a nice time, certainly a nice time.
Fantastic time, David.
What are you going to do now? What is the next move?
My next move is jury duty. Yeah. I got jury duty in Newark. Last time I had jury duty in Newark, parked my car in the jurors' parking lot, and there's a big sign in the jurors' parking lot at the courthouse, not responsible for stolen vehicles. So, you know, what can I say? And it just seems, you know, the 25 years, it has been 25 at least, you count the Carson time and stuff, you know, it went by very fast, and I've been sort of preparing for it gradually.
Yeah.
You know, in the last, say, 20 years. Really, you know? Every year I do less and less.
I see.
You know? Uh-huh. True. Oh, thank you. They're applauding yeah, indolence. Thank you for applauding indolence.
And how do the writers on the staff regard you as the man who's been around longest?
They think of me as sort of a writer emeritus.
Uh-huh.
I don't, you know, do any actual writing.
Right.
And I'm pretty much, I'm in my office most of the time reading papers.
Uh-huh.
And then periodically I come out and remind them of how much funnier the show used to be. So, you know, I guess they like me. I don't know.
Well, regular viewers to this program, if in fact there are any, will know know that you've appeared in many, many comic attempts over the years.
Yeah.
And tonight we have put together a little videotape montage. Terrific. Of those appearances.
Terrific.
Here we go down memory lane. Take a look.
It's Monday, August 25th here in New York City. I hope you all had a good weekend. I think I did. If the amount of the bail is any indication.
Gerard Mulligan, ladies and gentlemen.
On the road of experience, join in the living day. If there's an answer, it's just sad, it's just that way. When you look into space and find out who you are, when you look into
Very nice.
It's just been great, David. I can't say I've enjoyed every moment. I've enjoyed most of the moments. And it's just been a great ride all the way back to L.A. in 1978, 79.
And as I mentioned earlier in a note, thank you for your wonderful contribution.
Thank you.
Your creative abilities, your tireless efforts, and for sticking with me through my career. But mostly, and what's more important to me now at this stage of my life and everything is, thank you for your friendship.
Thank you, David.
Good to have you.
Thank you.
What do we have? What do we have for it, girls? Bring it out. Here we go. Let's go right over here. Give my best to your family.
Sure will, Dave.
We'll be right back with Jada Pinkett Smith, folks. Gerard Mulligan, ladies and gentlemen, motoring into the sunset. Thanks again, Jerry. In the 8 minutes that he was in that chair, he was funnier than he's been in 25 years.
Been saving it.
My thanks also to Gerard Mulligan. Bittersweet moment. We won't be seeing Gerard Mulligan here again.
Yeah, it was great to see him.
But I can't tell you, he's devoted 25 years of his life to making me funny, and that's a tireless endeavor. Good luck to Gerard, and also.